the Glendale 411. Ross Harbach, Nathaniel Bergstaller, and Nick Moore bring us a story on how you can see the Glendale 411.
Here at Glendale, tucked in room 245 is 21 Media 2 students who put on the 411 weekly. But does their hard work really pay off? We asked a couple students to see if they watched it.
No, I don't watch it.
No, I don't.
A couple times, yeah.
The teachers never show it to us, and then sometimes, like, I feel like whenever they have tried to, it's like doesn't work right, and then we can't watch it anyways.
As it turns out, most students don't realize the time and effort it takes to go into a show.
A show takes about like a week and a half, and we usually start right off at the school year because we want to get the shows off as fast as possible, get in our routine. It's really very diligent. You know, we have to work as a team. We have to have the ability to communicate with one another. People don't understand like the backdrop of like how like you have to get like a shot, like it's got to be perfect and it's got to be right on time, or it doesn't work, or it doesn't fit with your story, or the interviews have to be good, and there's like certain like aspects of like shooting that people don't understand.
So we wondered, what is the real reasons teachers aren't showing the 411 regularly?
I don't know. I know that I watch it, but I have the luxury of being able to watch it in my office. When I was in a classroom, I know that sometimes we had to get something covered before a test, and that was important for the kids. What I'd like to do to make sure that everybody could watch it is figure out a way that we could show it at lunch, and then that way if teachers did have something pressing or we had an unexpected emergency where there was like a fire drill or somebody's lessons got goofed up, then we would still be able to have a way to show it to the students.
But your 411 staff is doing something about it. They created a website to make the stories more accessible to the students.
As long as it's on a website, I probably watch it.
Like, kids don't have to watch it necessarily in class, but they have the opportunity to go home and watch it at home, and maybe with their parents would be cool, or with other students. I think that gives them an opportunity to not only watch it maybe in class, but watch it outside of class. If they see something cool, they can show their family.
So check it out, Glendale. Signing out for the 411, this is Nick Moore,
Nathan Bergstaller,
and Ross Harbach.
Next, Lauren Beatty and Peyton Sheet show us why the vending machines are closed during lunch.
As Glendale students return to school, many are noticing changes around the building. Vending machines surrounding the lunchroom and around Glendale are now closed during lunch hours. We sat down with a few people around the building to discuss these changes.
No, it's a district-wide thing. We were given information last week, and we're still trying to get clarification, so there could still be more changes coming. We just don't know what they are.
Well, I don't really use them all that much, but I feel like they need to be open because some people use them. Like, that's some people's lunch. And the food, the cafeteria food is gross.
It's really disappointing because I used to buy my lunch from there all the time, and now it's just nasty.
My understanding is that they have to be closed during the lunch hours. And I think they can be open before school and after school and like during class, but not during third block. But
well, I bring my lunch from home now, and I mean, it's better than actually buying lunch from school because
it has to do with the nutritional guidelines. And the situation is, in order for a school to receive federal funding, they have to follow the federal nutritional guidelines. And so if we want money from the federal government, we have to do what they say. The guidelines are getting narrower and narrower, and of course we have to comply because we need the money so that we can supply stuff for our students.
I mean, if they want like less people in the hallway or whatever, but...
I mean, I don't think there's any advantage to it. Everyone's kind of like angry and disappointed.
Very negative. I think unfortunately that while the intent is fabulous, the follow-through is ineffective. I'm not saying Springfield Public Schools, I'm not saying Glendale Cafeteria Ladies, because they are gems, as we all know. But it's pretty rare for a football player to get up at 6 and have lift weights and then go to lunch and be filled up on 5 chicken nuggets. It just doesn't happen. And a lot of these students only get breakfast and lunch at school, and when they go home there is not dinner, and so we're putting so many restrictions on them that they are hungry.
Signing out for the 411, this is Lauren Beatty
and Peyton Sheets.
Glendale is getting an extensive makeover. Hayden Folk and Steven Nernberg bring us a construction update.
Glendale has been under renovation since the spring of 2014. These renovations will bring our school a new library, cafeteria, and commons area. We got the inside scoop and a tour of the new construction. Here is Glendale Administrator, Mr. Ewing, to tell us more about the construction.
The three biggest things are the new commons area, the new and expanded cafeteria, and the new and expanded library. The commons area is probably going to be the biggest addition just because we haven't had a commons area like this before. So it's really coming together and it's really going to be sharp, I think. The cafeteria and library, obviously, with that space, with, you know, the kids and lunchtime, and of course they're already getting to experience a new serving area. But when we finish the commons area and the rest of the cafeteria area, they'll have a lot more room to sit. We'll have new cafeteria tables. So just the benefit of enjoying lunch a little bit more. As far as the library, I think you're going to see a library of the future, so to speak, in terms of technology and just the space. And our librarians, Ms. Foles and Ms. Van Gorp, are going to share with us kind of the vision of the library as we get into that and move back in.
Next, Ms. Van Gorp tells us more about the new library.
Very excited. Ms. Foles and I are looking forward to opening and getting out of this little classroom that we're in right now. Things that people notice first is that there's going to be three new little study rooms and reading rooms on one side of the library, which is a new feature that we've never had before. And another thing I think people will notice right away is that we will not have a seated computer lab like we had before, where all the computers are in rows. And so I think those are two of the biggest changes that people will visually see right away. We've been told by Mr. Ewing that the construction should be done at the end of October. And if that's all on schedule, we'll probably open then at the beginning of November.
After talking with administrators, we met up with Glendale students to get their thoughts and opinions on the construction.
I think it's super annoying because we have no room to eat in the lunchroom, and you can't sit with all your friends, and it's hard to get through the classes.
I dislike the construction. I think it's very inconvenient for going to lunch periods because there's only one entrance, and leaving school is a lot.
The hallways are really congested.
I think it's kind of a hassle because we have to walk so far to get to our classes, but other than that, I mean, it's going to be good in the end.
I don't like it because it's really hard for girls because we don't have that bathroom over there by the office, and so we have to run around trying to find a place to go to the bathroom.
Signing off from the 411, this is Steven Nernberg
and Hayden Fulk.
Andy Pierpont and Mariah Stark show us the GHS Ice Bucket Challenge.
It really touches home because of Coach Bell. He was a softball and baseball coach here, and he suffered from ALS and lost his life last year, and he had a big impact on the Glendale community. It's not too late. I'm hungry for the food that won't come, and we could make a feast from these crumbs, and we're all staring down the barrel of a gun. So if you're like, we raised about $3,000 all to go towards the Howard Bell ALS walk.
Finally, we have some highlights from the Welcome Back Assembly.
Game off, give and take, you can't hurry love. No, you just
next week when we bring you stories about Quest at GHS and Coach Ben Monk.